In the previous movie, you saw that SparkVue alone can be used to create SparkLabs that are functional, but perhaps a bit plain-looking. In this movie, I'd like to begin to show you a technique that allows you to create more professional-looking SparkLabs. Before I actually begin that technique, though, let's take a look back at the SparkLab that we created in the first part, using the basic technique. The reason I want to revisit this is we need to begin distinguishing between page elements that are static and those that are interactive. Static elements are things that students just view, like images and explanatory text. Interactive elements are data displays that show live data and places that students can type into. So let's look at the pages of our SparkLab and try to distinguish between the static and the interactive elements. Well, page one is just for viewing. There's text to be read and an image to be looked at. So I'm going to indicate that all of the elements on this page are static with the color blue. On the background page, we have two text boxes, of course, but these text boxes serve different roles. On the top, we merely have explanatory text. Students merely read it. On the bottom, there's a place for students to type a response. So on this page, there's static content on the top and interactive content on the bottom, indicated in orange. On the data collection page, the static content is in the upper right, the instructions for collecting data, and everything else is an interactive data display. On the conclusion page, we again have a layout where there's static instructional text on the top and a place for students to type a text response on the bottom. So, static and interactive. Now that we can see the distinction between static content and interactive content, we can take advantage of an opportunity to improve the appearance of our static content. The reason we can make it look better is static content can ultimately be created outside of SparkVue. So, in this and the following movie, I'm going to show you the technique for enhanced SparkLab authoring. I'll show you that we can use presentation software like PowerPoint or Keynote to create the static content. Wherever we know there will ultimately be interactive content, we'll leave a blank spot. The presentation software can export these slides as image files that can be brought into SparkVue. And it's in SparkVue that we'll add the final interactive content to the SparkLab to finalize it. So, with this process in mind, I'd like to spend the rest of this movie showing you how presentation software can be used to design and create the static content of the SparkLab. To enable the use of presentation software to create this static content, we've created templates for various software applications. On Windows, we have a template for PowerPoint 2007, and for the Macintosh, templates for Keynote 09 and PowerPoint 2008. I'm on a Windows computer, so I'm going to start the creation of this static content by launching the template for PowerPoint 2007. You can see this template file consists, for now at least, of just one slide, and this is a slide that presents instructions that are specific to the application, in this case, PowerPoint 2007. So I'm going to quickly run through these instructions. The first one is to convert my template file into an actual presentation. So I'll save it as a PowerPoint file. I'm going to put this on the desktop and give it the name of the lab I'm creating. You can see that this template includes some guidelines, both horizontal and vertical. This makes it easier to ensure that my static content won't be intruding on spaces that are reserved for interactive content. We'll see more about that later, but if you don't see the grid lines, you can turn them on following step number two. Now, it's pretty easy in PowerPoint to change the color theme, so I know that if I change the colors, it's going to look a little better for this particular lab. All right, now to actually create the static content, I'm going to put the insertion cursor above this instructional slide because I want to create slide number one, which you'll recall is the title slide. From the Home ribbon, I'll choose the New Slide dropdown, and here you can see the real power of the template. This template includes popular layouts for SparkLab configurations. In this case, I'm going to create a large image with a title, so I'm going to choose this layout and begin to edit the content. And I'll use this placeholder to add my image. And because I'm not constrained like I was in SparkVue, I can move these elements around. So I might make it look a little better. Move and change the properties of the text. All right. And I'm happy with that as a first page of my SparkLab. Now, because all this content is static, I didn't really have to worry about these guidelines. Now, the second page of our SparkLab includes both static content and interactive content, so I'm going to create only the static content in PowerPoint. An appropriate layout for this one might be this, split in half, top to bottom. And this is the background page. And I'll type the background text in question here. And the question to prompt students to make a prediction. Okay, that static content looks good. Now, ultimately, I'm going to add interactive content and interactive text box in SparkVue on the bottom half of this page. So I want to ensure it's just blank space in my presentation. So I'll select this placeholder and delete it. And slide 2 looks good. On the data collection page in our SparkLab, the only static content we need to create in PowerPoint is in the upper right, the instructional text for collecting data. So I'll insert a slide number 3 with an appropriate layout, maybe this one, and begin to type the instructions for collecting data. PowerPoint recognizes this as the start of a list and formats it for me. Okay, so I've written the 5 instructions for collecting data, and I do have a problem here. In the bottom, I'm going to ultimately have interactive content, a digits display, and I don't want my static text overlap that is going past this horizontal guideline. So let me do a few modifications to this text to make sure it fits inside these guides. I might decrease the font size a bit. And even reduce that indent. And that looks good. It's now going to fit inside the allotted space. Now, because ultimately PowerPoint's going to be exporting everything that is static content as an image, I have the opportunity to do things like mix images and text together. So I think this instruction list might be enhanced by having images of the buttons that students should press, just in case a student isn't familiar with the Spark device. So I'm going to quickly insert appropriate images. For starting, scaling, and stopping. And this page looks good. We have empty space for the interactive content coming up. All right. And finally, on the conclusion page, we once again have static on the top, interactive on the bottom. And instead of creating this page again in PowerPoint, I'm simply going to duplicate slide number 2 and make some quick changes to it. And with that, I've created all of the static content that I need in PowerPoint. So first, I'm going to save this file as a PowerPoint file with all the content I've created. Most importantly, I now need to create image files from these slides. So I'm going to choose to save this PowerPoint presentation as a set of PNG or portable network graphic images. I'm going to save this to the desktop, and I'll name it so that I can remember that these are the background images for my lab. And I do want to choose to export every slide as an image. Okay, so let me just do a quick check of those images. I have a folder of those images on my desktop, and I can see that I have the static content for each of those 4 slides, and of course, this slide that I can ignore with the instructions. Now, because I use the template, I can have confidence that these slides are properly sized and of the proper format to be brought into SparkVue. And in the next movie, I'll show you how we can bring these images into SparkVue to finalize our lab by adding the interactive content.